Hey guys, it's Pikachu. Long time no see. Thanks so much for coming back to my channel. Today's video is going to be about one of the oldest junglers in the game, Morad. The video is going to be about three different levels of Morad with beginner, intermediate, and advanced techniques. This video isn't going to be detailing every single combo, but will be more like a roadmap plus how-to guide for tips and tricks that Morad players use at three different levels of gameplay. For tricky heroes like Morad, I personally feel like it's a very big ask for a player to just figure out everything simply by watching someone else's gameplay. It's a complex hero, and so that's why I decided to make this video to list out the main skills of a beginner, intermediate, and advanced Morad player in detail. But as always, before we get into the actual video, we're gonna take a quick look at some of the montage plays I played using Morad. Hope you guys enjoyed the montage. If you're new or wanting to learn Morad, use this video as a reference to incorporate these tips into your gameplay. And if you're an experienced Morad player, let me know if you have anything to add in these categories in the comments below. Now, let's get into the video. In the beginner category, we first have the skill number 1, gauging distance with your S1 across different points in the map. Basically, you want to get used to how to cover the distance with your S1 at different spots, such as the two lanes, across your own jungle, in the enemy jungle, and so on and so forth. You can practice using your S1 through and around the walls. The second skill is now using monsters to get your stacks for your ultimate. The beginner skill is to master using the birds in both the top and bot lanes, the dragon, and the minions in the red side jungle. The third skill is taking advantage of the timing of Morad's abilities between Morad's ultimate and his S1. Most of the time, you want to ensure that you can dash back after using your ultimate. And you also want to make sure that you're creating enough space with your S1 so that you're safe when you teleport back. This is all part of mastering the timing. An additional thing to practice now is start timing the S2 to dodge a tower shot. The first skill in the intermediate category is properly clearing the jungle by minimizing damage and hitting two minions at once. How this is done is by casting an ability to cancel the minion's auto attack. Watch as I use my S1, S2, and ultimate right when the red buff is about to attack me, which cancels the auto attack. This means that I take zero damage, clearing the entire camp. Next, you can leash minions towards each other and hit them both at the same time with your ultimate. The second skill is the further development of ability usage. Particularly, using the S1 and S2 as offensive poke tools and the manual casting of Morad's ultimate. Hitting both of Morad's S1 and using the S2 to slow the enemy is key to either forcing the enemies to recall or getting kills without having prior stacks. Between each ability, auto attack whenever possible. This is also a great tool to tower dive enemies who are low. For the ultimate, it's time to completely master the skill by first switching to manual targeting. It's much better to aim the ultimate yourself than to let the system do it for you most of the time to get the best possible placement, especially in teamfights. The third skill is to utilize the enemy jungle to pressure the enemy team. Morad keeps the pressure high by using the enemy jungle minions as a way to dive the enemy turrets. The key thing here is instead of killing the enemy minions, use them to get your stacks. You can dive every enemy tower in this manner. By mastering the map completely, you unlock much more possibilities to control the game and to kill enemies. Finally, we have the advanced level. After mastering map positioning, farming, and intermediate ability usage, what takes a Morad player to the advanced level is all about maximizing Morad's ability kit. Instead of particular skills, I wanted to list out how Morad can use his abilities to the fullest potential. First, let's take a look at Morad's S2. Morad's S2 is extremely versatile and key to his outplay potential. Morad's S2 can be used as both a tool to slow down and zone an enemy to set up your ultimate, or a tool to dodge key enemy abilities. Afterwards, utilize the ultimate as both a source of damage immunity and finalizing kills. Since Morad's ultimate cooldown is longer than that of his other abilities, you can either keep auto-attacking before casting even if you have maximum stacks, or hold it until the optimal time to cast it depending on the enemy's abilities. Lastly, let's take a look at the advanced usage of Morad's S1. What makes this category advanced is the speed of the cast and when to teleport back. The first part is being able to cast the S1 to cover distance as fast as possible. The next part is to use the XS1 as a means to reposition to a more favorable location. When you master Morad's individual abilities, it becomes easy to get stacks off using the enemies to unlock Morad's ultimate instead of using minions. This is done by auto-attacking in between abilities, just like when farming minions. Now, let's take a look at some of the plays that take advantage of all of these concepts. The first clip I want to break down starts off with me just farming as I'm kind of waiting to see if the enemies are going to get into range. Once my teammates are low, it's enough to bait them to commit. Watch how I use my S1 to hit the backline instead of Ormar. I go for Thorn first because he's most vulnerable, and once my ultimate is unlocked, I wait until I walk up and then ultimate so I hit every portion of it. Then, I walk towards their jungle so I get out of their vision, renew my stacks, and dive back in to get the triple while still using the S2 to immune the tower shot whenever possible. The next clip starts off with me getting stacks off the blue buff as soon as I see the enemies. Then, watch how I place my ultimate towards Wukong and then I teleport back because I created distance with my S1. I then use my S1 to dodge Azunka's ultimate. While I ultimate, Scud comes in and luckily my S2 cooldown is down so I can use it to dodge Scud's ultimate timing. Then, I restack on the enemy minion and look for Azunka who went up the lane while being able to teleport back. Well guys, that was the end of the video. I hope you guys enjoyed it and let me know what you guys think in the comments. This is a new type of video that I created, inclusive of the beginner, intermediate, and advanced stages of learning a specific hero as well as why. For now, I've only done this for Morad, but if you'd like to see more from the series, definitely let me know in the comments as well as which hero you'd like to see it for, and I would be more than happy to make these videos for you guys. Finally, I wanted to give a huge, huge, huge thank you to all of you guys for continuing to support me and my channel until this point. I recently broke 3,000 subscribers on YouTube and it really means so much to me, so thank you guys for coming along with me during this journey for YouTube and for Arena of Valor and for liking, commenting, and sharing my content up until now. I'd also like to give a huge thank you to Official Arena of Valor for giving me a shout out on their official Discord, Facebook, Instagram, as well as Twitter. The shoutout really means a lot to me and it really motivates me to keep on trying my best to create content that's both informative and entertaining. So thank you guys so much and I hope you all have a lovely day and I will see you guys next time!